Hey, what's up guys? Welcome back to another Dead by Daylight tutorial. Today we're talking about Larry's, and just like always, the timestamps are going to be listed in the description below. And we're literally just going to jump right into it because I have a lot of dumb shit to talk about. The best way to get a grasp on indoor maps like this is to understand the shape and like the location of things, which is an obvious statement, I guess, to say. But most survivors don't seem to know the shape of Larry's, and so we'll talk about that right now. Larry's is a rectangle. If you take the smallest room in Larry's, like the normal little rooms, and use it as a measuring tool, Larry's is 3 by 6.5. Basically, it's 3 by 7, but it's closer to 3 by 6.5 rooms. So when you imagine Larry's, you should imagine it as a long rectangle, essentially. And with that, there's 3 types of major rooms that you should know about, and 2 of them are super obvious. The first one is the main room with the like torture chairs or whatever, and the stairway and the generator. That's, in my opinion, the main room. The next room is the library, which is what I consider to be like Shack, but that's the only reason why I don't call it the main room, because I don't call Shack the main building on any map. So there's the main room, and then there's the library, and then there are long rooms, which are like super powerful rooms that a lot of survivors take for granted on this map. They're actually super strong rooms. On every single map, you have those 2 main rooms, and then you also have 2 versions of the long room, which can change from time to time. Sometimes it's like a bathroom, sometimes it's like a bed, like with the beds and stuff in there. It changes around. The thing is, and most survivors don't notice this, but all 4 of those landmarks do not change locations. All 4 of those rooms are always in the same exact spot, and I'm gonna teach you how to know where they are right now. So there's a hallway on Larry's that runs vertically up the map. It's the main hallway. It's the hallway with the glass ceiling, like the windows, and it's like blue light or whatever comes through. That hallway is the centerpiece of knowing where everything is. That hallway always leads to the main room, and that hallway always has a long room running on the left side of it, as well as a long room running along the right bottom of the map. And then across from the left long room is always the library. Now things change, like the long room, like I said, can have different variations in it. And the library can rotate, I'm pretty sure it can rotate all 4 ways around. Like it can rotate all the way around as far as its orientation. But all these rooms are always in the exact same spot and usually with similar resources. So keep that in mind, that's Larry's. And those are all the best resources in Larry's. Like there's filler pallets and things in the smaller rooms. Of course, they're useful to an extent. But for me, the best spot in Larry's is right by the long rooms, kind of in the hallway. But we'll get to all that later. For now, just know these locations, and now we'll go over the main rooms, and then we'll go over how to loop them. All right, so the first room I want to talk about is the main room. That's the one with the generator and the lights and the torture chairs or whatever. The most useful part of this room, in my opinion, is the windows on the outsides of the room. Some windows are weaker, but this window that I'll show now is basically a T window. And if both windows are available, which means the basement stairs aren't on the other side, then you can basically use this like a really wide T&L wall, although I usually just use it like I'm looping a single T wall, and that usually means 50-50s. But it's a super safe window, and sometimes there's other windows around it that can be strung together. So the main room, in my opinion, the best part is this window. The other thing about this room is there's 2 super unsafe pallets. And just like we talked about in my first video, which again, I'm gonna link in the description below on all these videos, I'm just always gonna link it. We talk about unsafe pallets. And so since these are unsafe pallets, typically you wanna try to get a stun to maximize your chance of getting to another resource in time. And then I'll give you an example here where when you don't get a stun, this is, you have to either panic vault or the killer is just gonna, basically you're guaranteeing the killer a hit unless you're super lucky or you 360 or something like that. One more thing I should note is if you do go upstairs and the generator is not completed yet, you always want to go up and hit this window because this will be the only open window until the generator is completed. And sometimes the killer will vault behind you and you have a lot of distance basically to get to something else. Well, a lot of distance relative to if they just drop down the hole, which I don't understand why every killer doesn't just drop down the hole. I think it's way quicker. But that's the drop down. And of course, once you complete the generator, like I said, more windows will open. It'll go from 1 window being available to 3. Keep in mind, some of these windows will be unsafe compared to other ones, but I'm not gonna talk too much about the basics of looping because I point a lot of that out in my first video. But again, it's important to know that these windows open when you finish the generator. And yeah. The next room we're gonna talk about is the library. I call it the library even though it's probably a office or a study or something like that to fit Larry's actual theme. But anyway, there's 3 main components to this room, and that's the long wall vault, the office desk vault, which can either be the actual desk or a window vault as well. And then there's a god pallet. And keep in mind, god pallets are pallets that once you drop them, the killer literally has to break them, or you can just vault the pallet back and forth whichever way the killer goes. That means the killer has to go incredibly far around the pallet in order to actually reach you. Or a shortcut would be like a window or something like that. But even then, they will not be able to reach you as long as you just vault the fucking pallet, right? God pallets are incredibly strong pallets that, in my opinion, you should not drop unless you're about to go down. In my opinion, the desk vault, or even when that vault's not there and it's the window vault instead, that area, to me, is super unsafe. Like, whichever one you roll, it's hard to play around because there's such a blind spot. Like, if it's the desk, there's an incredibly big blind spot with the wall being solid. If it's the window, then it's not super safe either because it's such a short wall for the killer to run around. You could probably get a couple of panic vaults out of it, but in my opinion, the real star of this setup is the long wall. And if you don't know anything about long walls, you need to go to the first video where we talk about long wall jungle gems, because this is literally a copy paste of a long wall. It's just been retextured to be a Larry's wall. Looping this wall effectively after like the first initial vault when you lead the killer here usually ends up being 50-50s. But like I said, we talked about this in a previous video, so I'm not going to go too in depth on this. Just know that as long as you vault through the window and go around the bottom of the L, you can either fake the vault or dedicate to the vault depending on what you think the killer will do. And then again, the god pallets on the side. It's important to note that the rooms surrounding the library are unique to this exact spot because the library steals about 25% from each room so that it can fit in this spot, and that creates really unique rooms. These rooms never have pallets in them, but occasionally these rooms will have a strong or kind of strong window vault that you can segue off of this area if you need to escape. And occasionally in the hallways around these rooms, going even further away from the library, there will be pallets and things like that to use as well. But we'll talk about the other resources outside of the library later. It's just important, in my opinion, that you know that once you've used the resources of the library, and maybe not even the pallet because you should save that, you can segue to other loops right outside if you know where the window vault is. But at this point, I'm just rambling. Just know that there are other resources on the way out of the library, but they're unique to this area. And as long as you know they're there, this is like a really punishing area to be. Probably one of the best areas to be on Larry's. All right, now we're gonna talk about the long rooms. And what I'm gonna get to eventually is an area that, in my opinion, which I know I've said a lot already this video, but in my opinion, it's stronger than main and library, even in the example I just showed. So let's talk about the long rooms first. These long rooms always spawn a really long, super safe pallet loop in them, okay? Sometimes you get the bathroom one that's easier to see over, and in like cases like Huntress and maybe even Deathslinger to a degree, these are less safe. And then the other room has like hospital beds with like the curtains up so that you can't really see that well through them. There's a little bit of obstruction. And these areas will be kind of harder for the ranged killers like Huntress and Deathslinger to shoot over and things like that. But both rooms are fundamentally the same room. They have a really strong loop in them and usually a window similar to the windows that I just showed outside of the library. I'm not really going to talk about how to loop these. These are basically just filler pallets, and we've covered these more than once in the past in the other videos. But the thing that I do want to talk about that I think is super, it's the strongest area in all of Larry's, right? It's literally just a double window and a pallet and a long room that spawns in this spot on the map. I'm just gonna show it on screen because I don't really know how to explain it. There's an intersection that is made with the main hallway and the second to last horizontal hallway from the bottom of the map, right? And in this intersection, like I just said, there's a double window and usually a pallet nearby, and you usually have the long wall pallet as well to use. Not only that, but there seems to be like 5 or 6 pallets right in this area. So if you're up by main, I think you're fucking up. The real spot you want to hang out on this map is down in the lower half of the map, where you have library, the 4 rooms that you can string windows together, the 2 long room pallets, and the long room window, and in one case, the double long room window. Like, I don't even know how to teach this. Like, how do you just, all you have to do is just vault these windows and just lead the killer one way, go around the other way, vault the window again. And you basically have a window formation that, unless the killer does like some really big mind games on you, you can just vault until they're locked out, use the pallet, get to the long room, and get to another window. And like, I have, I don't even know what I can teach. I don't even know what I can teach. It's mindless. I'm surprised it exists. But yeah, that's the strongest place in Larry's. All right, guys. So now I'm just going to talk about a couple of things that I don't think fit anywhere else in the video, but I still think are super important for you to know. The first thing is the location of this other god palette that spawns in one of two places, both of which are the outside edge of the long room tiles found on this map. So they're either on the left side of the left room or they're below the bottom room. Again, it's a god palette because if you drop it, unless it's like Huntress or maybe Pyramid Head or somebody that can hit you through pallets, there's nothing the killer can do if you drop this palette. All they can do is kick it or run all the way around like an idiot while you just vault a pallet back and forth. They have to kick it. Other than that, I realized I need to mention all these like filler pallet rooms that exist at the top of the map. There's like, what, 7 of them, 8 of them? Some of these rooms are completely useless. They don't have a pallet in them. I think all of them have at least one window vault, but the ones that have pallets, there's a way to loop around the pallet that will always give you a fast vault. So if the killer doubles back a few times, you might not even have to use the pallet. You might just get a window vault for free. So here's a good example of like the direction you need to loop here. And then if you loop this way, like you would never get a fast vault for free, if that makes sense. Like you always come at an angle that makes it hard to get a fast vault if you loop it this way. But realize if you are looping this in an efficient manner where the killer is giving you something for free, you don't have to use this non-renewable resource. You can use the window, which is renewable, and save the pallet for later when somebody else is in a more deadly situation than you are. The other thing I should mention is that one of these windows uniquely vaults to the stairway, which kind of isn't that good for you. Unless the generator is done in the center, there's no good vault up the stairs. But that's my point I want to make, is that if the center generator is complete in this example, then you can vault this window, go upstairs, and immediately vault on this window that you know is there as long as you know that generator is completed. Since I'm mentioning the fucked up windows, the window directly across main from that window we just talked about is the kind of like opposite, where if you ever vault out this window with the killer right behind you, you're kind of fucked because you're cornered and the only thing you can do is vault back, and they're just gonna immediately flank back around the wall. And again, unless you gamer on them, just like the unsafe pallet example, you're gonna have to 360 or something, or you're just gonna give them a free hit in this case. But yeah, I didn't really talk about the corner pallets that spawn on the map. There's other filler pallets all over the map, but you guys have learned plenty by now about filler pallets from my first video. So you can apply the skills that you've learned from those videos for the rest of the resources on the map. There's no reason for me to waste more time talking about things you already know, or things you can access in another video. So with that being said, thanks for putting up with me talking about Larry's for a super long time. And somebody in the comments below, let me know how many times I said "in my opinion," because in editing it looked like it was a lot of times. So also, if you're watching this video when it first comes out, I should be streaming at twitch.tv/yourcrush. That's a 0 and a 5, by the way. So if you want to come show some support, you can click the link under the video or just look me up on Twitch. And yeah. Anyway, thanks so much for watching. Like if you like, subscribe if you like me, and I hope to see you in the next one. Have a good night, guys.
I love this game and everything about it. She should find another gym. Honestly, I don't tried to bait him with his spring burst and he hit me from like 5 miles away.
Like, I should have died because his first lunge was easily.
He left. No, he's on me. I have a long room though now.
We're on gen. Like, there's like two set of chairs and pallet between them.
He's DCing? He's DCing? Maybe. He's leaving me.
What'd you do?
Looped him on a double window. Too powerful, dude. Too powerful.
Hey, there you go. You got one clip.
That's all I need is that intro clip.
Take it.